leader, another contender for the Labour leadership, has emerged. Owen Smith, a Welsh MP, who used to hold the shadow work and pensions brief, of course. He's thrown his hat into the ring now. That's ahead of what promises to be a very big week for the party, with a vote on the Trident nuclear deterrent. That's tomorrow. Well, let's speak now to Hilary Benn, the former shadow foreign secretary, whose sacking by Jeremy Corbyn seems to have started all this, sparked those mass resignations from the shadow cabinet. And here we are now. Why aren't you going for the... Good morning. Why aren't you going for the leadership, Hilary
Benn? Well, good morning, Dermot. I'm not. And I'm backing Angela Eagle because I think she's got integrity. I think she's got a huge amount of experience. But above all, she's demonstrated extraordinary courage in the last few weeks. She has stood up and said, I'm going to challenge Jeremy Corbyn for the leadership because we desperately need new leadership of the party. We have an unprecedented situation, Dermot, in which 80% of Labour MPs have said we don't have confidence in our leader. And it's impossible to see how Jeremy Corbyn could take us into a general election in that situation. But the decision now rests in the hands of party members, and I'm sure they'll think long and hard about the vote that they cast when the ballot papers go out.
I'd say we've got Owen Smith now joining the fray. We knew that for quite a while, but he's confirming it. Would you say, I mean, and Owen Smith has said it himself, that it would be better that one challenger took on Jeremy Corbyn. Would you agree with that and say, back at you, Owen Smith?
Well, I think that would be preferable, and that's why I'm backing Angela, because I think she is the person who should be challenging Jeremy, and she came out first, stood first. Owen has many qualities. He'd also make a great leader. But we have to see what decision the Parliamentary Labour Party makes. We have the hustings tomorrow. But it's also not just about that, because constituency Labour parties also have the opportunity to make supporting nominations, and that will give an indication of the range of support out in the country before the ballot
papers. But just on those hustings, Owen Smith seems to be indicating, well, whoever's got the most support out of that, they should be the one, the sole challenger to Jeremy Corbyn that goes forward. Would you accept that?
Well, I wouldn't, because what I was saying to you is it's not just about the decision that the Parliamentary Labour Party makes, although, of course, that's hugely important. The party out there has a chance to make supporting nominations, and we should test the water there. There'll no doubt be a lot of nominations for Jeremy, but there will also be nominations from constituencies for others, and I hope that Angela gets a lot of nominations, and then people can make their own judgment.
We haven't got much time left. Yeah. I thought constituency business had been suspended by Ian McNicol, partly because of all the abuse that's going on there.
It has, except for the purposes of essential business to do with Labour Party conference and the making of the nominations. But you're right, the Labour Party is in a pretty unhappy state, and I think
McNicol's talking about violence and intimidation. I mean, some of these must be a bear pit.
It's really very difficult, and it's distressing because, you know, for all of us who've devoted our lives to the Labour Party, been members a long time, the sort of abuse that is being directed at ordinary Labour Party members, whatever the idea was behind a kinder, gentler politics, it's not what we have seen. And I'm sorry that some of those, and it is a minority, but some of those who are supporting Jeremy seem to think it is acceptable to abuse parliamentary colleagues, particularly women members of the PLP, and others. If you don't support Jeremy, then you get all sorts of abuse. And we cannot be a party like that. And not only do we have to call it out, but we need a new leader so we can heal what is clearly a very divided party at the moment.
So what happens? Everyone is saying the same thing, including Jeremy Corbyn, that once the result is in, whoever it may be, we've got to unite behind that leader. Do you go along with that, even if it is Jeremy Corbyn?
Well, we need to see what the result is. But I think for Labour members of Parliament who have said, I'm afraid we don't have confidence in your leadership, I suspect people will continue to hold that view because it. Look, I served in his shadow
cabinet.
The
hesitation, Hilary Benn, people are going to say, is he nearly going to say the S word? Are you thinking of a split if Jeremy Corbyn?
No, absolutely not. Let's be very clear about this. It's idle talk in some newspapers. I've been a member of the Labour Party for 45 years. I intend to die in the Labour Party, but not for many years yet. And we are passionate about the values and beliefs of our party, and we're staying. We're not going anywhere, and in the end, this problem will eventually be sorted out. But the fundamental difficulty is we have a leader who cannot command the confidence of those he's meant to lead in Parliament. And there's two parts to the job. You are the leader of the members, that's true, but you also have to lead the people in Parliament, and that is clearly not working, and it's not sustainable.
And then we see that very divide in the House of Commons on the issue of things like Trident. whereas you've got a free vote now, Labour MPs, and the majority of you are going to go, yes, we want to renew the system, and your leader wants to get rid of it.
Well, Jeremy has long held a view, and I admire and respect his principles. I disagree with him, because I think the first duty of government, and indeed of a party that aspires to be in government, is to defend the nation. And I want to see a world, as he does, with no nuclear weapons. The issue has always been, how do you get there? And Britain giving up ours alone would not persuade any of the other nuclear states to do it. Who knows what the threats will be in 20, 30 years' time? Nuclear deterrence has helped to keep the peace, because it says to any potential aggressor, and what are we talking about here? Preventing an attack on our country. Having the nuclear deterrent says to them, I really wouldn't think about it if I were you. Anybody want to live in a world, Dermot, in which nobody had nuclear weapons except North Korea? Well, I wouldn't feel safe okay. in that world, and I suspect nor would you.
OK, well, it illustrates the wider point, though, doesn't it? That if Jeremy Corbyn is returned, these things will just reoccur and reoccur and reoccur again. The majority of MPs going one direction, but being prisoners then of the leader who... they kind of united around, they won't split the party. You remain as an ineffective opposition and then get smashed apart in another general election.
Well, that is why Angela went out in front and said, I'm going to challenge Jeremy, because this situation cannot continue and we need a strong and effective opposition, particularly at a time of great challenge for the country. The consequences of Brexit, what's happening around the world, what happened in Turkey on Friday night. We need an effective opposition, and if we aren't effective, then the communities that we represent, the people whose support we wish to win, will face continuation of what is a right-wing Conservative government.
And just last question again, the one I started with, Hilary Benn, you won't reconsider not standing. I mean, when you resigned, people were thinking, oh, OK, or, sorry, when you were sacked, were thinking, well, Hilary Benn would be a very good leader of this party.
I'm not, and I didn't take the decision that I did to say to Jeremy I no longer had confidence in him because I wished to lead the Labour Party. I told him that because I believed it to be true, and I think you have to be straight and honest about these things.
Hilary Benn, good to see you. Thank you very much indeed for your time.